Hello, Sheena Douglass here with Pretty Pastels, as you can see. Gorgeous. Now I'm all set up, ready to play. This is how I would suggest you prepare your aquatints. As you know, in your packs you're going to get a pipette for each colour. Just simply squeeze your pipette, lift it up, and then you're going to get all that paint ready to play with. Then you can simply, look, if you let go, nothing's going anywhere, transfer it to a palette. And then you're good to go. So I've got a palette ready to play with. We can pop that out of the way and we'll just work from this. So the tray that comes with them, I would strongly suggest you leave them in that tray to stabilise them. If you get more sets, then you're going to have spare trays and you can use them as a palette, or just buy an expensive palette with those little wells in to pop the colours in. So this is the colour that these are the colours we're going to look at. This is the little chart for those colours. So you can see, even though the pastels, the colours are very definite, really clean, pure, beautiful, really pretty colours. And this is just one coat. Now, I've probably mentioned before, but I'll say it again, I like to make a little colour chart, write the number of the paints on the colours and pop those on my lid so I can say number 59. That goes on 59 jar and it is the purple, rather than having to look at the sides of your jars when you're popping your lids back on. It's just much easier. So shall we get started? And I'll show what I thought was we could do some techniques with this set, and of course you can do the same techniques with any. The first thing I'd like to show you is just layering. I love this look here. It looks kind of like shadow print and you've got colours mixed on top of colours. Really, really effective here. The other technique we're going to look at is salt. Now this isn't with the pastels, with another set, but you'll see what it looks like with the pastels. And the last technique with this little video is going to be the cling film. Now this is a different set again, and it's with the gold from the essentials over the top. But you'll see what it looks like with just the process is exactly the same. So of course you can do any of these techniques that I'm going to show you with each set with any of the other sets, okay? So we'll pop that to one side. First thing, let's talk about layering. Now I've got a piece of watercolour card here, just A6 size, just really easy to start with. Whenever you're painting, I think it's much easier, it makes more sense to me to start with a lighter colour. So we'll start off with the yellow, and I'm just going to make sure that hopefully that your brush is clean. I'm not sure how clean mine is, but I'm going to just paint splodges of blocks of colour, random blocks of colour. Okay, then I'm going to go on to the orange, and then I'm painting another block of colour. Doesn't have to make much sense, kind of like my world, just wherever. Then I'm going to go ahead and paint. Make sure you're wiping your brush or wetting or cleaning your brush in between each colour, because I will say the pastels will contaminate. You'll see really easily if you can't cross, pollinate or contaminate one colour with another, because again those colours are so clean and bright and pretty and pure. Again, I could be speaking of myself. So just blocks again, keep going. I'm kind of trying to leave some room for some other colours, bit of purple in there. Don't worry if you kind of reach borders and one colour goes into another, because we're going to do more of that shortly anyway. A bit of green, pop maybe some on top of there. Kind of want an area with, you know, where I can see a bit of pure colour with all of them. And on there. Now, there's kind of run out a bit of space there. What I'm going to do is I'm going to dry that first layer. Okay, I want to dry that where you can pretty much see blocks of the pure colour. Then I'm going to come back and we're going to paint another layer on top. So see you in a few seconds.
Here we are back. Now what's spooky is you will find with your pastels that when they dry they seem to become stronger. Look, woo, they look much stronger than when I was putting them on. So now we're going to go over and just do the same.
So I'm going to start with yellow again, but this time I'm going to put it on top of another colour, because we're kind of blocking and mixing colours on top of colours to give it much more interesting kind of effect. And it's about layering. Because of them being pastels, you're going to, you know, mix colours as you're going, which I think is quite good fun. Put orange on there. Maybe put a little bit in there. You see how they're starting to merge, but some of them you'll see through the colours underneath. Others are kind of like might block in more of them.
across there. Blue down there. Looks much more interesting. I mean, it looks more muted because you will, you know, eventually find a brown and kind of colours in there, because, you know, if you have your red and your green together will give you a browny kind of colour. But it's all the fun of it. I think that makes it much more interesting. And then what you can do is just go ahead and dry that again, and you've got a really, what I think is quite a funky background. So just give it a quick blast. See how the colours are kind of merging and smooshing, but you've got colours showing through other colours. And then what you can do, even, like I've got one I'm going to show you in a sec. So what you can do is, if you want to give it kind of like more of a warm cast, is you can just go over the whole thing with some yellow. Don't scrub and scrub, because then you'll unsettle the colours you put down on the first layer. Another thing to mention is this will still for bleach. So we'll drop some water on there, which is one, I think, one of the strongest features of AquaTints. The fact that you can actually, the colour lifts so well. Just look at that. Isn't that fantastic? So for interesting, grungy, but in a pretty way, backgrounds, techniques, they're a winner every time, but they're easy to do. So that's the first one. Here's one I made earlier. Okay, a bit more washed. And I'll show you a couple of cards where Donna has used the same technique for in a couple of samples of cards there. This is Donna Ratcliffe's card, one of my design team. And see in the background all the colours? Gorgeous. Alright, next technique. Okay, this time, same thing, you're going to need a piece of watercolour card, or, yeah, we'll use watercolour card, could be stamping card, whatever, and we're going to splodge a lot of colour on here. So just take it up, be quite generous with it. I'm kind of trying to leave warm colours together and cooler colours together. By that, if you look on my palette, I've got red, yellow and orange on one side, and then I've gone down to more the purple and the green and the blue on the other. So just go ahead, you've got to be quite liberal with this. Of course, where you put your blue, you're going, next to your yellow, you're going to get green. Pop a little bit of green in there. Okay, then what you do, try and get it so that it's not bending, try to bend it back. You can tape this down with some you know, masking tape if you want. Then take some, I've got some fine sea salt here. All salt works. Depends on how big the grain is, you're going to get different effects. And then just sprinkle it on. I like to be a little bit random. Don't have it all just an even sprinkling. Put more in one area. If you've got a lot of paint that's wet, you can put more, because you'll get more of an effect. And what that's going to do when it dries is it's going to make the paint push away, and it's going to make kind of like a corally kind of faceted look. So leave that at least an hour to dry. And then I'll just wipe this up. Always just be wiping your desk up, especially when you've used the salt, because it kind of, you know, it can mess up your other backgrounds if it gets on your foam or your brushes and things and scratch. One I made earlier, there you go. You can see this one has still got the salt on it, feel. But what you do, just rub the salt off. How pretty is that? I think that is just really, really interesting. That is such a lovely, lot of texture and interest in there. Now I've got another one. Don't know what it's going to look like, but it's going to give you a different effect. This one, same palette on Centura Pearl. Now, it's more muted because the Centura Pearl is less absorbent, so the colours have sat on the surface and mixed together more. So you've got much more muted colours, but look at how cool that looks on Centura Pearl. Isn't that fab? Really, really easy. So simple but so effective, and of course that'll work with any of your others. There's a larger piece there,
and just, you know, works a treat, any of your other palettes as well. Right, last technique with this video, we're going to look at cling film. Okay, same thing, we're going to take some card. You'll see a pattern emerging here. You can use your brushes that you came with the set as well. In fact, you can also, just if you want to make your colours go a little bit further, you can spritz the card. And be careful with the pastels though. If you spritz too much, because they're already really, you know, pale and interesting, you might dilute them too much where you lose, you know, the colour. So I wouldn't wet them too much, but you're just going to go ahead, add some colour like this. Say similar things that I've just done, so I'm just, you know, building on a theme here. Fab. And then you're going to take some cling film, you're going to scrunch it up so that you've got lots of little wrinkles in it and it's looking all kind of more interesting than just flat, and then pop it on your surface. The more wrinkles you have in it, the more interesting it's going to be. And what's happening there, so you can already see where the paint's pushed up, where the little cling, the film has gathered and congregated, when that dries, it's going to create facets in that. And it's going to look gorgeous. And I can show you, we've got one to reveal of that as well. So pop that to one side. It needs at least an hour for that, because obviously with the cling film, there's no air getting through there. And then, I've already got these two prepared. Don't even know what they're going to look like yet, so we'll find out together. Ooh, I like that. I love this colour up here. So, ooh, I like them both, actually. Weird. Look, it looks like it's got a kind of a shine. You'd think there was metallics in there where the aquatints have kind of congregated. Can you get that? I love that. Both colours are gorgeous. Really nice. And then, again, since you're a pearl, you get a whole different ball game, a whole different look. So it looks like you've got mica in the whole thing. If you want to see it with some other colours, just quickly, this is it on with another colour set, and you can see the gold over the top. That's just making sure you've got some of your gold very, very diluted from your essentials in there. And this is another set. This is what looks like it could be the primaries or even landscape. And that's it. So there are your techniques. You've looked at colour blocking and overlaying. We've looked at the sod technique and cling film. And that is just a tiny touch of what you can do with your aquatint. So look at all your other boxes. Give them a scan and see what other videos we've got for you. And for more inspiration, go to crafterscompanion.co.uk or even Sheena. TV, and you'll see galleries of gorgeous cards on there. Thank you very much.